Lois Liptak joins us with her friend Bella. Thank you so much, Lois, for joining us. Let us talk about Bella and about why you are here. You are legally blind, and Bella obviously helps with that. She's from Southeastern Guide Dogs. Tell us your story. You were a nurse at Hilldale Hospital for a long time, weren't you?
Yes, I worked intensive care for a long time.
Yeah, and now, tell us what happened and how you are now working with Bella and kind of opening up a second chapter to your life.
Well, with macular disease, you lose your central vision, and that is the disease process that I have. Uh-huh. And it took me out of the hospital completely because you can't do that type of work that I did.
Right.
And so I'm now actively working as a medical masseuse. Mm-hmm. And still continuing to help people, get better without a surgical procedure. And
tell us the story about getting to meet Bella and how you two have gotten together to advance things.
Well, the South Carolina Commission for the Blind, mm-hmm, kind of hooked me up or told me about getting a guide dog. And I contemplated it for a long time and decided that that would be a good thing for me to do. And so we put in the application. It took a year and a half for me to get the dog.
Wow.
And because they go through training and different processes, they are raised from puppies. They have what they call a puppy raiser.
Okay.
And then from that point, they go on to the school where they're actually trained, and they spend 6 months of intensive training there. And then from that point, they introduce the student, like myself.
Right.
And we just spent 3 weeks in Florida. The Southeastern Guide Dogs is located in Palmetto, Florida.
Okay.
And we spent 3 weeks there doing intensive training. I often associate it with intensive care.
I was going to say, yeah, you know the hospital terms for all of that, and it really is a lot like that?
It is. Yeah. It is very intense. It starts at 6 in the morning, and we work until 8 o'clock at night between training and obedience and lectures and street walking and introducing the dog to the student out in the street in the community.
Okay. And now it's 24/7. How long have you two been together?
It's been approximately like 2 months now.
Okay. And everything's going well?
Everything's wonderful.
Bella doesn't seem to mind.
No, she's quite the dog.
That's
when
fantastic.
I mess up on commands, she reminds me.
She fixes you up, that's for sure. Southeastern Guide Dogs is the group. Tell us a little about them.
They operate on it's a nonprofit,
right,
organization, and they have a tremendous amount of volunteers, and without the volunteers, they would be probably spending about $35 million a year to operate.
Wow.
But they are strictly based, strictly funded by donations of corporate industry, private people who realize the benefits of it. It is a very peaceful environment. And when you go there, absolutely everything is free. So it doesn't mean that, uh-huh, you have to have a lot of money.
Right.
All you have to do is have the qualifications.
There you go.
Bella likes to stretch a lot.
Bella's stretching a little
bit.
Yeah. Lois, the numbers are on the screen during this holiday season. I think folks should give some thought to the Southeastern Guide Dogs. Thank you so much for bringing them to our attention. You and Bella have a wonderful day, and good luck with the rest of your life in this new chapter. Thank you so much for joining us. We also want to thank Lois Liptak and Bella, Jill Dowler, Shannon Biedenbaugh, and Hannah Horn for their input. And we thank you for sharing your time to check us out on the Hilton Head News. I'm Bob Stevens. We'll be checking you out around our island home this week.